Hey guys, welcome to another episode of Talking Moments. My name is Talking Makinwa. It's another week and the vlog is here. Well, I've got hair in my mouth. Let me just take that out of the way. I'm so excited this week. Can you tell? Yeah. It's been a very long day, but I thought to myself, you know what? I can't go to bed. I can't eat. I can't do anything unless I shoot the vlog because I have a pressing issue that I want to discuss today. People have been writing to me, and instead of doing like an Ask Talker, I read through as many emails as I could, and I thought to myself, you know what? This is a very important topic. There are many people who are in relationships with themselves. They're in relationships, but by God, they're better off being alone. You know, the sort of relationships that just drain you and just wear you out, and you're basically looking like a shadow of yourself. Your friends can't tell you because they're scared that you totally fall apart. Your family's worried about you because you're slowly but surely becoming a shadow of who you used to be. So I am here today to talk to you, as I always do every Wednesday, about some relationships that you are better off without, okay? Regardless of how long you guys have been dating, regardless of, you know, all the things he says, ew, that's the problem. When they say, you need to be looking at what they are doing. It's not about what they say. Anybody can say. I can sit down here and say. Yes, I love to bump my head when I'm talking. But it's high time women start to look at things that are being done to them. How he treats you, how he treats himself, how he treats people around him. You find out the things that he's not saying by what he's doing. Cha-ching, you get my drift? So let's just call this truth time. It's time for us to tell ourselves the truth, okay? We ladies, sometimes, you know, you keep thinking the men are to blame. The men do this, the men are that. They're so horrible and they're so wicked. But the truth is, there's some things that we can do for ourselves, i.e. we can work on ourselves and work at accepting things as they are. So I have a couple of points that I'll be sharing with you, and let's just do this hashtag you're better off alone, all right? You're better off alone if every single time in this relationship you're crying, if the happy times are getting lesser and lesser and lesser, and all you do every day is cry. In a week, at least you cry 4 times. Are you a bloody onion? Why are you crying? The drama is becoming more. The sadness is becoming more. You're literally always crying. You're always sad. You find out that you don't smile that much because you're always thinking, oh, what if he breaks up with me? Oh, what if he's just acting this way because he's tired? Oh, what if he wants to leave me? Look at your face. Crying. Why are you crying? Why are you always crying? So it's a man that you came to this world to be crying for. You cannot cry for your finances. You cannot cry for the homeless and helpless people that are displaced on the streets. All you do all the time is cry. Why are you crying all the time? You're better off alone. Why are you always crying? You know, he tells this, you're crying. You feel as if he's behaving strange, you're crying. You need to pick yourself up, look yourself in the mirror and realize, you know what? I'm not an onion. Why am I always crying? Why does he always make you cry? The one who deserves you will not make you cry all the time. I mean, what kind of life is this where all the days of your life you're spending crying? People will see, how are you? And you're like, I'm just there. You know, you wear sadness like a cloth. You're always sad. God will not give you sadness in your life because of a man. Is it that serious? Eh? Somebody cannot talk to you. Next thing, you burst out crying. He said, I think, I feel, he's behaving funny. If you're crying all the time, you're better off alone. Trust me, you're better off alone. You're most certainly dating yourself. But you're dating someone who brings out the worst in you, and you're not happy. So what's the point? Oh, we've been together forever. Boo-hoo, so what? Bloody hell, he's not thinking about it. And the man you're crying for, just look at you. You have everything going for you. Fine, you are fine. Job, you have. You know, you stand well. You now be crying for one man, crying all the days of your life. That man is out with his boys having a good time. That man is out with another chick that is showing him pepe. The kind of pepe that girl is showing him. He's the one crying for the girl. Yes. You are there killing yourself for a man. The man is there begging one, Angelina, you have to go out with me. Angelina, I will die if you leave me. And then you are there thinking, oh, I've spent so much of my time in this relationship. Why is that always the case? It doesn't matter how long you've spent. The truth of the matter is, there's so many more years you're going to live for, and you have so many amazing years ahead of you. Why don't you just clean your tears, promise yourself that you will never cry anymore, and just pick your shoe and begin to move on. Number two, you're better off by yourself. If you realize that this guy can do without you, if you realize that a guy can live without you, yeah, everyone can live without each other, but when you're in a relationship with someone, it's nice to know that, okay, yeah, I can live without you, but I do not want to live without you. Do you know what I mean? And this person is doing things actively, trying to be in your life, actively trying to, you know, make decisions with you, actively trying to change the way you think. It's no longer I, but we. If you find out that it's all about I'm traveling this weekend, he can tell you maybe 5 hours before he travels. Doesn't feel the need to even walk you through what he's doing. You can't ask questions because the guy just shuts you off. You know, he's today he's here, tomorrow he's gone. If you're having a bad day, you don't have a boyfriend that you can even call and be like, hey, babe, I'm having a bad day. There's no pick me up in your relationship. You're always the one picking yourself up and picking him up. Honey, you are better off by yourself. If you're the one always doing all the work in the relationship, if you're the one always looking to him for the relationship to survive, are we going out this week? Are we staying at home this week? Are you my boyfriend? Are you going to marry me? When are you going to introduce me to your parents? If you're the one always emotionally available, if the guy always exits the building just like Elvis all the time, you are better off alone. 3, he keeps stringing you on. If you want to stay, stay. If you want to go, go. Yeah, there are people who are in relationships like that where the guy is literally treating you like, if you want to stay, good. If you want to go, that's the door. Why are you even bothering? Like, that's not the person you're supposed to be with. Like, why are you even bothering yourself? Like, you're alone. You're by yourself. Do you know what I mean? Like, this person is not responsible in your relationship. He's not available for you emotionally. And he just likes you being in his life, but he's not actively trying to keep you in his life. If you want to go, there's like 5 other girls he can hang out with, and you're just one of the girls. You are an option. If you are an option to the guy, you are better off alone. You're better off alone. If you know in your heart that you're an option, you can, we know these things. You know how, you know, this person is just with you, and he doesn't mind just being with you, but he's not ready to take this thing to the next level. You can be at this for 7 years, 6, 7 years, 8 years. You know, every time you want to have that serious conversation, he has other plans. The guy is just not available. The guy just doesn't want to hear it. The guy's just passing time with you. This guy does not have any plans for you. Does not have any plans whatsoever for you. You're better off single because all those years you have invested with this guy. Guess what? You could have stepped out in faith. You know, people are always scared to be alone. I don't know why. Like, the fear of being alone sometimes has so many women in horrible relationships. That's not a relationship. You're dating yourself. You're alone. You're better off by yourself. 4. You're better off by yourself if you are dating an NFA. No future ambition. A guy who will be taking from you. A guy who has no plans for you. A guy who doesn't even know what he wants with his life. You know, there are men who do not know what they want. They're just coasting through life. And then you now want to attach your destiny to somebody who is a coaster. Hey, you will hang. One chance. This is what is called one chance. The guy has not even sorted out his own life. You can't give what you do not have. Okay? If this guy does not know where his next meal is coming from, why are you deceiving yourself? Why must you hitch your tent, O Israel, to your tent with somebody who does not even have a canopy? And you are there sitting now thinking, okay, I'll just stay with him. Maybe things will get better. You are there providing emotionally, providing spiritually, providing financially. The man would even abuse you on top, take you for granted, cheat on you, follow different women. He's not even responsible. You know, this is a guy that can just go, you not even hear from him for a week. Next thing, he calls you. You know, one particular email I got where the girl was so distraught, and it really broke my heart. She was saying to me how this guy and her have been dating for a long time, and, you know, basically the guy just basically has no plans for her. She felt scared to introduce him to her family because she wasn't sure if the guy was going to stick around. And the guy would, you know, basically tell her things like he needs money, she'd be providing. And one time that she did not give this guy money, next thing, the guy just broke up with her just like that. Angry, just broke up with his babe. She didn't hear from the guy in like 4 months. Next thing, she checks on Facebook, the guy is getting married to somebody else. No future ambition. Well, at least no future ambition with you. Some people will just play on your emotion for the fun of it. They are just there to just be taking what they can take from you. You are not in a relationship. You can sit down, assess your relationship. Ask yourself, this relationship I'm in, self, how is this relationship doing me? Is this relationship adding to my life? Because I hate it when you see women who are beautiful, doing well, women who can do bad by themselves. Yet, they are just attached to some people that you'll be asking, Is it that they've shaped for you from where you are from? Eh? Is it that you need to go to MFM and clean this your head because this person is going to be your downfall? You know, because some of these guys cannot even rescue themselves. So why are you waiting for somebody who cannot rescue himself to rescue you? Do you not see that there's something wrong with you? Now, this week it was about the girls. Next week, I'll do for the guys as well. You're better off alone when you're hanging around some funny, funny girls. You want to know what funny, funny girls are like? Tune in again next week. That's all I'm going to talk to you guys about. Thank you for being awesome-tastic, as always. My name is Toka Makinwa. I'll chat with you on the next episode of Toka Moments. Subscribe, share, like with all your friends, and make sure you tune in again. Sorry, I'm not trying to scare you. Goodbye!